Hello and welcome to another episode of What is Happening in Brazil. March 8th is International Women's Day. We start today's show with a special report on the new ways feminism has found to broaden the gender debate and grow in society. Here in Brazil, some women are using the internet as a space to discuss the topic and create solidarity groups. They are digital influencers acting on different fronts and using their own experiences to talk about the economy, sexuality, relationships, health and beauty from a feminist viewpoint. They defend the notion that the issues that they are raising on the internet are jumpstarts that propel people to go more in-depth in complex social issues like racism, misogyny, and LGBT phobia. Take a look.
On many occasions, social movements have brought debates out on the internet. This is a win for the feminist movement in Brazil. This stems from the women that came before us. This debate didn't start on the internet. Not only for the feminist movement, but the fight against racism, the fight of black men and women. This debate has been growing, worked on, and exposed in different spaces. These spaces have extended to the internet and installed themselves elsewhere too, like mass media, for example.
I understand that the internet was in need of new characters, of new stories to be told. Also, that the internet is a powerful place in our society. Communication is called the fifth power. If it is, in fact, so powerful, and the internet is responsible for so much of our communications, I thought that this had to be a place of plurality. A place of pluralistic power, so we could share different narratives and perspectives there. I don't believe that the debates online are shallow. I think the internet is diverse, so there are shallow and profound debates on it. I understand the internet as a place in which to have access to new discussions. I think it's a starting point from which you move on to other places.
Eu acho que é um primeiro lugar ali que depois você pode buscar em outros.
A gente tem que pensar.
We have to think about how to reach out to people in a way they can understand and relate to. People need to see themselves, because from that point onwards, and this is something that happened a lot with the feminist movement online. When women spoke out, start hearing others, they could see themselves in others' discourse, and came to the conclusion, gosh, I'm not alone, this stuff happens.
Now, check out the latest news of the week.
Between the 5th and 9th of March, the first national meeting of landless women will take place in Brasilia, the country's capital. This event, which has the motto, Women in the Struggle, Sowing Resistance, will gather thousands of rural women and those from militancies all over Brazil, as well as comrades from another 15 countries. According to the leadership of the landless workers movement, the meeting represents the importance of women in the fight for land, education, healthcare, and their rights. The main discussion points of the gathering are the fight of rural women against the advancement of big capital, the fight against the patriarchy, racism, violence, and also the study of rural feminism. The idea is to include landless women in the feminist struggle with a basis in land reform. Former President Luiz Inácio Lula da Silva received the title of Honorary Citizen of Paris on the 2nd of March. It was the same honor bestowed upon Chief Raoni and South African leader Nelson Mandela. This title was given to Lula while he was still being held as a political prisoner in October of last year. At the time, the municipality of Paris said the award was given in recognition of Lula's fight against poverty and for human rights in Brazil. While accepting the honor, Lula was applauded by the audience. In his speech, Lula said that the suffering of the Brazilian people is a result of the attacks against Brazilian democracy. The former president highlighted that during his presidency, Brazil was removed from the world hunger map thanks to public policies of redistribution of income, but that it was all undone after the impeachment of ex-president Dilma Rousseff. Finally, Lula thanked the city of Paris and stated, "I will continue to act in defense of democracy and the Brazilian people."
Lia of Itamaracá, as the artist Maria Madalena Correa do Nascimento is known, is a major symbol of Brazilian culture and identity, making poetry wherever she goes. She has this name because she's from the island of Itamaracá, located in the state of Pernambuco. Lia composes and sings ciranda, a dance native to this state and characterized by the formation of a large circle. In 2005, she was recognized as living heritage of the state of Pernambuco.
Todo meu sonho era cantar.
My dream has always been to sing. I thought they were beautiful, those who sang, those who danced. I would always tell myself, gosh, I would like to one day be a singer, to sing for a big audience, for a lot of people, really, a lot of people, to feel each and every one of them. Then, in the 60s, a researcher that visited the island of Itamaracá heard me sing and asked me to sing her songs. Out of one of these came up the song. Lia gave it to me. She told me the song was good, that she would put some lyrics into it, and it would be a ciranda in my honor. I was 12 years old at the time. I came to record an LP in 1977. Then we had a concert, did a concert, in Recife, Itamaracá. Then I became Lia da Ciranda. I can say now my dream is fulfilled. I was baptized in Ciranda, and I am with Ciranda all over the world.
A Ciranda é uma confraternização.
Ciranda is a confraternization where everyone holds hands in harmony, with happiness, with joy. Ciranda has no prejudice. Whites dance with black people, children, old people. There is no prejudice. If you are in the circle, you dance. Ciranda is a force to be reckoned with. I feel very happy singing. I scream from the bottom of my lungs. Lia gave me this ciranda. This is really good to be recognized all over the world. I'm a warrior. I'm resilient. I love what I do. I adore what I do. I am Lia.
Eu sou Lia.
Now it's time for Brazilianism.
Oi, meu nome é Daniela.
My name is Daniela, and I'm gonna teach you how to make puba tapioca, which is a dough made from fermented yams. The basic ingredient is puba. Before placing the puba in the frying pan, I will oil it with a spoon of coconut oil. But you may use olive oil or butter, up to you. Here I'm using 3 tablespoons of puba. Now I will place the dough in the pan. This frying pan is quite large. At home you can use a smaller one. You are going to make a disc from the dough about 1 cm in width. I usually shape the tapioca before putting it on the fire. A small detail, when you start frying the yam, it will begin changing color, and that's the time to flip it over, when it stops being white and gets yellower in tone. A little bit of salt for seasoning. Now it's ready to be flipped over. Now it's a question of waiting till it gets a little golden. Now it's ready. We can eat this tapioca pure or put a sweet or savory filling in it. Here I will use an eggplant antipasto. To wrap things up, add a little parsley to give it some flavor and a special touch. And that's it.
That is it for our show today. I see you soon.